So today we have a round one Marsh Community Series team update. It should be fun. Yeah, round one went for 2 weeks, so still technically after round one, and we have another round coming up. I'm sure we'll make many more changes. Did I get carried away after round one? A little bit, not gonna lie. Lots of new faces in the team. Reading on Twitter, people saying, you know, stay disciplined, don't make too many changes. Man, I don't care. I like this. It's fun to change around with the team, and we can reevaluate after the right before round one, or in that week leading up to it after the Marsh 2 series round, whatever it's called. So we'll start off in the defense line, and I've gone back to the roots. If you follow the channel for the past 2 years, you'll know that I've gone either one or two premiums in defense, and we've done that again. I think this year it's going to be a bit of a scramble right before the Carlton vs Richmond opening game, because we really have no idea which rookies are going to be named round one. So I probably would leave that time open if you're doing stuff. Maybe tell the boss that you need to go home early, because it's going to be a bit of a scramble trying to figure out which rookies are getting named, because I don't think we've seen... I don't think I've ever been less confident in rookies before, so maybe they'll come through, you never know, but right now it's a little concern. But we have a lot of defender rookies who might be good, but we don't know if they're going to play or not, so we'll wait and see on that. And my D1, D2 and D3, start off D1, Houston, playing pure midfield it looks like, so we like that. That's a good role he can score in, and did okay in Marsh round 1. Jordan Dawson is very much a watch right now, but I like what he can do. He scored really well with Lloyd and Rampy and Mills in the back line last year. It was his first full preseason in 2019, so we like that. And I think it seems like the Swans had high hopes for him. Just needed to get his body right and his habits right, and he has done that. So I do like Dawson, a little bit unproven, but we saw in his first Marsh game, he was the general back there, pretty much. He had the license to intercept when he wanted, and he's a really damaging kick as well, one of the best kicks I've seen recently anyway. That's just watching highlights, so all the kicks are going to be good, but keeping a closer eye on Dawson, really liked his game in round one. And we have Dylan Roberton, not sure if he's fit, but the fact that he's in the leadership group says that they have confidence in Roberton, so wait and see on him. He just kind of fits the structure. Might turn into Lockie Ash, or see how we go there. But yeah, we'll keep an eye on that. Zerk Thatcher, I think we're going to call him Berserker from now on. Intercept guy, so we like that. Plays key defense, so... Yeah, took a lot of intercepts in the VFL. These are the sort of rookies we're after. It's just that he's expensive, that's all. So... I think he'll play round one from what I've been reading, but keep an eye on him. And then the rookies, whatever, worry about them in 2 weeks' time. Now the midfield. Okay, where's Patrick Cripps? I'm not sure. I think I'll still start Cripps, it's just I haven't decided which midfielder I want to drop yet. Over my dead body, will I take McRae out of the team? And I think Lockie Neal, because of his fixture and bye, and he plays De Boer right after his bye, I feel like he's a starting pick. It's going to be complicated trying to get him in, especially, you know, he plays North and the Crows in the first three rounds. He'll probably go up, I'm not sure he'll go up in price, but no reason why he shouldn't have a field day against them. But you can't really predict it, but he's done it in the past anyway. And then Josh Kelly, the upside of Josh Kelly I think is too good to give up, even though he's a risk. Surprised at how low his ownership is. I think that'll slowly creep up. But yeah, full preseason, I've said it for 3-4 months now, full preseason of Josh Kelly, he stays in. And that's what happened. We saw him in the Origin game. Make whatever you want of that game. But looks really fit, Josh Kelly. So, and then Dunkley and Bontempelli. Probably not as hot on Dunkley as I was a month ago. Starting to worry that Bont's going to get a little bit more mid-time. And then Libba might come in a month. Libba might play a month in. But I think Libba will probably be more injured throughout the season. So Still in Dunkley's game, high contested possession count. It was just Bontempelli's day, so Bontempelli took all the points that day. Still like Dunkley, you know, don't have the guts to drop him just yet. So then we have Temple, Bontempelli. We saw what he did in the first Marsh game, ridiculous. Didn't have the greatest Origin game. I don't know why I keep bringing that game up. The only reason why, I think it would be out of Bontempelli and Cripps. I'm not sure I can actually afford Cripps. Maybe, I'm not sure. The only reason why I would swap Bont out for Cripps, I love Bont. I think he'll go, it looks like he's ready to go up a notch this year. But I think the problem is he has the boar twice. I'm not sure I want to deal with that. I still think he'll score fine, but let's see, it's so contested for a spot in the midfield this year. Don't even have Fife or Dangerfield or anything, or Oliver. But yeah. So I think Bontempelli or Cripps, haven't decided yet. We'll see what happens. Cripps' ownership is so high, it might be dangerous not to start him. And then the rookies, whatever. Rao we pick. Pickett we pick. Pickett played okay. Lots of centre bounces, just didn't score well. I think he can score much better than that, given his role. Tom Green, if he's named, I think you start him. His highest, I think he had the highest percentage of contested to uncontested possessions ever. So yeah, I'm hearing Patrick Cripps comparisons to Green. Doesn't mean he'll be as good as Cripps, long way to go, but has that similar game style. So Tom Green, I think we have to pick if he's named. And then the bench rookies are a huge concern, to the point where I think we're going to have Buderich at M11. And then the rucks, big Brody Grundy locked away, and Riley O'Brien still. Not sure, I really like Gawn. Gawn's so good, and I think Gawn is probably, I mean, his average should have been 132 if he wasn't for injury, but with Gawn, I'm not sure, I still kind of want to start him. Looks like he'll play in the second Marsh Series game. So, the thing with O'Brien is, if I go O'Brien over Gawn, it means that I can turn a rookie into Devon Smith. And I'll speak about Devon in a second. I really like having Devon Smith there in a year where rookies might be a concern. I'll speak about that in a moment. Forward line, no Snortfield. Should I have him? Probably. Just doesn't fit right now. We'll see how we go, if I can fit him in. The thing is, I don't think I can go Martin and Whitfield with the amount of value going around. Maybe I'm just getting sucked in, but yeah, I like Martin. Martin has a really nice early fixture with the Melbourne games, and is he overpriced? Probably a little bit, but durable and yeah, star player. Shouldn't have any problem averaging around 100, so I'll take that. Now we have Parrish, Greenwood, Petrarca. Definitely watched a lot of the Marsh series, knowing I have these three guys. Parrish is playing more mid-time, I think, what it looks like anyway. Still will get rotated forward. Averaged 94 as a midfielder last year. And saw an interview with him and seemed like he was saying he wanted to take more midfield responsibility. That was about a month ago. Hugh Greenwood, Hugh's time on ground went up. His midfield time went up. So yeah, and he's still got that contested game. Again, he plays for Gold Coast, and he has a full preseason compared to last year. The upside is very clear with Hugh Greenwood. It's just that he plays for Gold Coast, and he did score okay in losses with the Crows, so I don't mind it. This pick has grown on me. I was initially a no, but now considering it. But yeah, just not entirely sure just yet, but like what I see, and his price is pretty good. And then Petrarca, we know the upside with Petrarca. I'll probably start him. He has to do something really terrible in the second Marsh game for me to not start him. Which is weird saying that. I wouldn't have dreamt of saying that 3 weeks ago. And then Devon. So I was reading somewhere on Twitter, someone said Devon Smith averaged that 98, averaging one or two centre bounces 2 years ago. I'm not sure if that's, I can't confirm that, but that's what I read. That's pretty good for him to score that well. And I think his pressure was off the charts in the Essendon versus West Coast game. So, yeah, I think he had 5 more pressure acts than the next best player, than the next player in line, something like that. So we like Devin Smith for that price. It's very low risk. If he's not a keeper, M9, F7 swing. Beautiful. Love it. So I think I want to start Devin. If I don't start Devin, it's going to cost me, it's going to get me to Riley O'Brien and then throw in another dodgy rookie. And then Stephen Hill in the forward line. No bleeding in the forward line. Forward rookies are not looking good. A few North rookies might come through. I think Hosey and Marnie, but we'll see if they get named. Rankin, I have no idea if Rankin can score or not. No one knows. We just know he has a load of talent. And Max King cannot be trusted on the field. Anywhere between 20 and 90 from Max King, I think. Probably more to the lower side. So no bleeding up forward. Good even spread. I think 12 players I'm picking as absolute keepers. Plus Devin, plus O'Brien, plus Robertson. I like that. Sure, I'll have to do 10 upgrades, but it shouldn't be too hard with Robertson and Riley O'Brien already having that money there, so making it easier to upgrade them. That's all from me. Thank you for watching, and we have a YouTube quiz league tomorrow. Should be fun. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.